All right, guys, so as much as, oh, here she goes. Hey, good morning, everybody. Welcome to the vlog. What do you say we make today absolutely incredible? And if you like big snakes, it is absolutely gonna be the vlog for you. We are gonna go ahead and clean Lucy and Daisy, and I'm gonna go ahead and see if I can just let Lucy run around a little bit, give her a little bit of exercise, because now, again, like I've been saying for a while, we have this new space where she can't get in quite as much trouble. We can keep her right here, and she can't really get underneath these racks, and certainly the pond is in the way over here. So as long as I can corral her in this area, we can let her kind of roam loose. But I have a feeling she's still gonna wear me out because she is a high energy snake. And let's face it, a 200 pound snake that is nothing but ribs and muscle is a lot to handle. But we're gonna do our best to give her a little bit of stretching out and just let her run around while Mary and Kelsey are cleaning her cage. And then we'll do the exact same thing for Daisy. Regardless, it's gonna be amazing and I'm gonna have a great time, but I think I'm gonna get a little bit of cardio in. So what do you say we go ahead and tackle Lucy first? So more than anything else, people ask me what it's like to hold big snakes. I mean, let's face it, that's a pretty amazing thing. And you know, a lot of people have held little ball pythons or maybe garter snakes they find or little things. Big snakes are completely another thing. I mean, especially when you get into reticulated pythons that are high energy. Lucy is almost 20 foot long, a couple hundred pounds, and she is so much fun, but she's also very challenging. And people ask me all the time why I don't breed big snakes, and it's because I think that not everyone should have big snakes. It's not that I'm against big snakes whatsoever. I'm just saying that you do need a certain amount of experience before you tackle something like that, because they're big animals. So I think that when I'm gonna produce snakes, like big snakes like that, which we are considering breeding Lucy, I wanna produce a very small number so that I can really pick who gets them so that I know that they can be responsible. Again, that's not against anyone that's doing it on a larger scale. That's just my personal opinion. Regardless, let's go ahead and take Lucy out and give her a little freedom and hopefully everything will go okay. Ready? Uh-oh, look at that. Oh, anyone that knows about snakes knows that when snakes are in blue or getting ready to shed, they're a little bit more cantankerous. And the reason is they can't see. See how her eyes are really blue? That is a milky secretion that kind of goes throughout the outer epidural layer of the skin, and then it absorbs into that outer layer, making it moist so that they can shed it off. But the problem is that milky secretion actually clouds their vision, which means that they're a little more defensive. Anyways, this should be a challenge.
You okay, girl? You all right, sweetheart? You okay? You know that it's me and it's okay.
Everything's gonna be all right, girl. Don't want you to crawl over on yourself, sweetheart. All right, perfect. Uh-oh. Okay, so already she's got me a little bit going here, but I'm trying to calm her down. To be honest with you, in this case, her being a little blue, uh-oh, whoa. She turned on me quick, guys, and that was gonna get ugly really quick. You can see she is in a very bad spot right now.
All right.
I'm definitely gonna have to be really cautious today. I think that her being in blue is making her a little bit more defensive. And I have to be really careful. She's a beautiful animal. Oh my gosh, I'm in trouble again. Oh, she is really fired up, guys. You're okay, girl. You okay, girl? Uh-oh. You all right? All in the day's work right now. Here she is, underneath here. Oh, shit. So basically, again, what's happening is Lucy is sometimes a little defensive already, and now with her eyes being clouded over, she she's even more so. So any kind of movement, her initial action is to lash out. We just have to be a little bit extra careful. Lucy is a tiger reticulated python, het for lavender albino. She's about 7 years old now. We actually hatched her as a baby, so she's been here her whole life. She's really a great animal, but again, big snakes are one of those things that you have to really get a lot of experience with to be able to read them, because you can see I read Lucy as soon as she turned on me. If I wouldn't have been reading her and sat where I was, she was absolutely gonna bite me. And again, I've taken bites by animals the size of Lucy before. It's not fun. I mean, it's not the end of the world, but it can, especially if they rip, you can end up in the hospital with stitches. I am very fortunate that girls like Lucy here, this beautiful animal, have never been to the hospital for stitches, because I typically read them very well, and then when they do strike, I never pull away. That's how you get hurt, is when you pull away from a strike. So, all right, we're gonna go ahead and just keep on messing with Lucy and giving her an opportunity to run around a little bit. I am in a terrible spot right now. You couldn't get in much worse spot than this. She is fired up, she's ready to strike, and she's got me completely around, so there's not a whole lot I can do. So I just have to be super calm and just try to make slow movements and hope for the best. Fortunately, I've got my snake hook, so I should be able to defend myself to some extent. It's okay, girl. You're gonna be all right. I promise.
Whenever you're ready.
All right. Whoop. All right, girl. Oh, crap. Woo! All right, guys. So as much as... Oh, here she goes. It's okay, girl. It's all right. It's all right, girl. You're okay. You're okay. You're okay. You're okay. You're right, sweetheart. I'm in such a bad spot, guys. Okay. So I think the best thing to do right now is to get her back in her cage. As much as I wanted to give her a little freedom, better get her back in her cage. Watch yourself, guys. It's gonna go forward, not backwards. Woo-hoo. There you go, sweetie. You're okay. All in a day's work. That's okay, sweetheart. You're right. There you go. Get back in there, sweetheart. You're a good girl. What a beautiful snake, though, huh? I mean, I love this animal so much. And that's it. All right, we'll give Daisy a little more room. All right, so now that we've gotten through the fun of handling Lucy, Daisy is gonna be a piece of cake. Of course, she is still high energy. She loves to move, but she is also extremely docile compared to Lucy. Not that Lucy's mean, she's just more defensive and you have to read her more. Whereas Daisy, really, I've never had her strike at me before, so I think we're pretty good there. But she does still give you a cardio workout. So let's go ahead and have some fun with Daisy. Okay, my girl Daisy here, she's holding on to me pretty tight. I'm gonna set her down so that she can get a little bit of pressure off my neck. Now, of course, Daisy is a lavender albino reticulated python and is the same age as Lucy. We just don't feed her quite as much or as big of meals. We wanna keep her a little bit smaller so that we can take her out around kids a little bit more. Whereas once they get the size of Lucy, it becomes a little bit more difficult. There you go, girl. There you go, sweetheart. What an amazing snake, huh? I mean, just take a look at how gorgeous that thing's head is, and just amazing. Look how big that head is, too. I mean, that is a monster's head snake. Ah, she is so good. I thought it's so much more pleasurable handling Daisy than Lucy. I love Lucy, but you always gotta be on your guard with her because you just never know what's gonna happen. Whereas with Daisy, it's just really about keeping her in check. You don't have to worry about her swinging back and biting you or anything like that. And again, I'm not painting Lucy as a bad animal, just different temperaments, you know, and Daisy has always been amazing. Look at how gorgeous she is. You know, I just noticed that Daisy's eyes are starting to go a little blue too, so she's in the very beginning of shedding. But she's not so opaque or blue-eyed that she can't see really well, but that's probably one of the reasons why she's not moving around as much as she normally does, because normally she's much more active than this, which is good for me, because it gives me an opportunity to have a little time with her without having to chase her around everywhere. Ah, she's such a great animal. So again, Daisy is her normal self, beautiful mentality, beautiful animal, never have to be concerned. She is definitely heavy. You know, if you're wondering, she's getting about 18 and a half foot, and she's probably only about 150 pounds. So she's a good 50 or 60 pounds lighter than Lucy, but she's still a lot of weight when you carry her up. So I just love spending time with her. She's such an amazing snake, but we'll go ahead and get her back in because obviously she's starting to get ready to shed too. So I don't think either one of these guys are going to eat this week because they're in shed. So let's get Daisy back. And there you have it, guys. My two beautiful big reticulated pythons, Daisy and Lucy. And I got a little bit of an aerobic workout before I have to head to the gym. All right, guys, what do you say we go from handling the largest pythons in the world to the smallest genus of pythons in the world, Antaracia? And Antaracia is made up of basically four species of small pythons that are native to Australia. This happens to be a spotted python, which is the Antaracia maculosa. Now, these guys are typically found on the east side. They'll go as far up as Cape York, all the way down into the New South Wales area. And then this is actually a mutation of spotted python that's called Granite, which is a recessive mutation. Now, the other three species would happen to be the anthill or pygmy python, which is Antaracia parthensis, which is basically native to the northwestern part of the country. And then there's the Stimson's python, which really look a lot like the spotted pythons, but a little bit more interesting pattern. And those guys are basically more native all the way to the western side of Australia that comes all the way basically to the Great Divide, but basically in the center parts of the country. So you don't find them really north and you don't find them really east. And what are you doing down there, guy? We have the python coming to see me. And then lastly, of course, would be the Antaracia childreni, which are actually a children's python, but they're not because they're made for children's. It was actually named after a guy with the last name of Childrens. But the Antaracia are a great species of small python. They're very diverse. My buddy Peter Birch from Criticam has the most amazing Antaracia collection probably in the world, with all kinds of colors and patterns, and oh my god, they are absolutely incredible. So it's just interesting to go from a large python like a reticulated python that is really the longest and largest snake in the world to a genus like Antaracia, the spotted, children, Stimson's, and pygmy pythons, and see the difference in them. But again, these guys are just little pint-sized pythons and I love them to death. All right, guys, so I'm gonna wrap it up here at the shop. What an amazing day. I tell you what, handling big snakes is so incredible. If you ever get the opportunity to do it, or if you ever come visit me, you make sure that we do it together. You will absolutely be blown away. It's a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity, and I get to do it all the time. As for now, I'm going to head home because Noah's got another one of his bad choice challenges that we're going to be doing. I think it has to do with, like, super hot food. I'm not even 100% sure. Regardless, I'm sure I'm going to be regretting my decision to continuously try to be on his channel. But I'll put the link down in the description, guys, so that way you can check out his channel. Thank you so much for supporting my family and supporting my son, Noah. I love him so much, so make sure you go ahead and sub to him. As for now, I'm out of here. All right, guys, so this is the aftermath.
Can you see it? Does it look, I think it's red all around here.
That's right, we did the blazing wing challenge. I was a complete wimp. Noah crushed some stuff, but then I think he kind of got sick. It was hilarious. It's still painful. Noah is messed up for sure. So I will go ahead and put the link down in the description. You guys can see this crazy video because trust me, this was the worst decision we ever made. Those things are unbelievably hot. Regardless, guys, thank you so much for tuning in. Like I said, please check out his video and subscribe for me. You guys mean the world to me and have an amazing day. Can you do me a couple favors? Can you hit that like button? And make sure to turn the post notifications on. Be kind to somebody. I promise I'm gonna see you tomorrow.
stereophonic sound for the home is recorded on two separate tracks, each one giving special emphasis to certain sections.